In this video, we will show how to troubleshoot your Vizio model number E470i-A0 by testing the voltages to the LEDs on the power supply / LED board. If you have this model and the symptom of no backlights, this will help to show if the problem is with the power supply / LED board or if the actual LEDs themselves inside the TV are bad. If you have the symptom of a blank screen and need to check and see if you have backlights, please click the annotation link in the video for our flashlight test video. After viewing this, you can come back and then continue troubleshooting if you have no backlights. So, if you have determined that you do not have backlights, please continue watching for more troubleshooting help. Be sure to take all of the proper safety precautions and only run these tests using a meter if you have the proper training, skills, and tools necessary. Try all repairs at your own risk. We will be checking the voltages at a connection point in the corner of the power supply / LED board. This connection point goes from the board directly into the panel. When checking these voltages, be sure the TV is plugged in and turned on. We are going to be checking the voltages at VOUT1 and VOUT2. There are two sections of LED strips in this TV. The area highlighted in red on the connection shows the test point for each of the sections, both 1 and 2. The proper voltages for these, with all things working, is around 100 volts. So if you test VOUT1 and VOUT2 and get 100 volts, give or take a few, then the power supply / LED board and the LEDs are working well. If VOUT1 and VOUT2 show as 0 on the meter, then you have a problem with the power supply / LED board and it should be replaced. You can purchase replacement boards on our website. If you get voltages that are much higher, closer to 130 volts at VOUT1 and VOUT2, then you have bad LEDs in the TV and they will need to be replaced. It is recommended to replace all LEDs in your TV at the same time. So, for example, if you have around 130 volts on VOUT1, but VOUT2 is closer to 100 volts and working normally, you will still want to replace all of the LEDs. We do sell replacement LEDs, but it is recommended that the LEDs are replaced by someone who has experience or is a trained professional. This repair can be difficult, and you can damage the TV panel in the process. If the TV panel is damaged, it is not repairable. Click any of the annotations on the screen to watch other videos to help with your LED TV repair. If you have any further questions regarding your repair, simply post a question in the comment section below. We strive to learn and share new TV repair tips every day. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and grow with us. Share our videos with your friends to help us spread the savings. And don't forget to hit that like button.